is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. If you're a customer of SolarWinds Orion Monitoring products, you probably are already way ahead of me and already doing what you need to do to block network access to servers in your domain. For those companies who do not use SolarWinds software, I'm sure you've seen the news and the headlines. For you, this is actually an opportunity to review your own processes and determine if you'd been able to know if your servers and your software had compromised backdoor code. As noted in the instructions provided by the Department of Defense, what should you do? So, do you have the technical expertise to investigate the systems? Perhaps you have cyber insurance, in which case I would say immediately contact your cyber insurance policy carrier, see what process they tell you to do. Can you do forensic images of the systems? There's a piece of software called Access Data FTK Imager and allows you to take forensic images of hard drives, CDs, DVDs. It actually allows you to preview the contents, mount an image for read-only, and creates hash values of files so you can better investigate. You don't want to do your investigation on the actual live system. You want to make sure you image that system and take it offline. Now, the good news is Microsoft has partnered with other key partners to actually seize the domain in question and blackhold it so that, or actually make a kill switch out of it so that it can't be used in attacks. Now, that said, take the time to investigate whether or not you could look in your firewall log files for any kind of investigative signs. Some of these attacks have been going on for months. So the first question you should ask yourself, do you have the resources in your system and log files to hold data for that long? If not, look to a long-term solution such as Splunk or Azure Sentinel to store these log files so that you can later on investigate. Both Splunk and Azure Sentinel have actual queries that you can go through your firewall logs to investigate whether you've had attacks. If you don't use those products, reach out to your firewall vendors and ask them for resources. And again, even if you weren't specifically targeted in this attack, think in terms of what resources do you need if you needed to do this kind of analysis. Next, a topic that I'd recommend that you look up is something called Kerberosting. And you want to make sure that you can turn on logging for Kerberosting. Now, Kerberosting is not a new topic. It's actually been around as long as 2014. And there's some really good resources out there on adsecurity.org so you can read up more on what the risk of Kerberosting is and how you can better protect yourself from it. One of the key ways you can mitigate against this is ensuring that service accounts passwords are longer than 25 characters and are not easily guessable. Then you can also look to see managed service accounts and group managed service accounts are also a good method to ensure that the service accounts passwords are long, complex, and change regularly. Now, I also found it of interest that the SolarWinds attack sequence, the attackers actually verified that there were no security software on the system, such as they were looking to make sure that there was not WinDBG, AutoRuns, Wireshark, WinDefend, Sense, or CAVP on the system. So it was interesting that they knew if there were sysinternal tools on the system, they didn't want to install themselves and run on those systems. So again, think in terms of, do you monitor your systems? Do you use tools such as sysinternals? In particular, do you install Sysmon on your systems? And think in terms of, what do you do for monitoring? Ask yourselves, could you have determined if your systems were backdoored like this? I want you to take the time to review what you might have done to be alerted to intrusion activity in your network. Think, what if you were in that spot? We may not be able to prevent these attacks in the future. I don't think we actually will be able to prevent these attacks, but hopefully we should be able to be alerted to them. Until next time, Take the time to check out the other videos on the IGG Tech Talk YouTube channel. This is Susan Bradley. Stay safe, stay secure.